Hello everyone, I'm Pearl Pereira. My business is P3 Designs and I design quilt patterns, mostly applique, but I also love to do small craft projects. I have been in my house now, I think for 17 days, by order of my grandchildren to stay in and that they would do all of my errands that I need to do and my shopping. So while I am here, you know what happens when you're home alone? You get in trouble. So I decided that I would make face masks. And for my face mask, I looked at several patterns out on the internet that were free. I tried a couple of them and I found that they were all basically made from a rectangle shape, very generic. Some were very wide, some were not so wide. But the most thing I found about them is that when you put them on, there was a gap here and you had a gap here. So they don't really fit the contour of your face. So I decided that I was going to make a better mask. And once I did this, then I also decided that I'm offering this mask as a free pattern to everyone who wants to make it. It is yours to use, make for yourself, to make masks and donate them. The only thing I ask is that you do not copy or publish my written instructions. The pattern looks like this, and it is a 7-page document, and I have full color photos in here of each step for those of you who need something written. It'll be in PDF format. You can download it from my website at p3designs.com. You'll go into the tutorials, you'll find the video, and below that you'll find the link to download the pattern. So with all that said, I am going to show you what my my design is. And I've designed this mask that is contoured. It has darts. It also has a curved edge here. And I think that it fits better around the face. Not so great with glasses, but it does fit better around the face. So I'm going to put this on. And I think that you can see that it covers better here and under here. Of course, you probably couldn't hear me, but I think you better tighter fit to your face. And you can make this in three sizes for children using the same pattern. Children, you know, general, normal size people, and maybe a large for, you know, men, women, and children. The only difference is in the size of your elastic. And I found that to be the same with most of all the other masks that I looked out there on the internet. So I'm going to get my things together here and I'm going to show you how to make this mask, and I hope you will enjoy making it. So look forward to seeing photos of all of you with your mask on. Okay, we're back. First thing I want to show you is what you actually need to tools and supplies that you'll need. You'll need it. I used a pair of pinking shears. You don't have to use these, but I'll show you why I like to use them later on. You will need a pair of scissors, small scissors, and a larger pair of scissors for cutting out your pattern if you're not cutting it out with your rotary cutter. I used my applique pressing tool, my stiletto when I was sewing. I usually use a pencil, but for the filming, I'm using a black Sharpie so that you can see the lines much better. You'll need some pins, an ironing surface, and a ruler. So the first thing that you're going to do is you need to cut 2 7-inch or 6-inch for women, 7 for men, and 5 for children pieces of elastic. You'll need a 10 by 7 of a focal fabric. I call this the front fabric. And you want a backing fabric, which is I did it in a contrasting color so that you would know which is the right side, which would be the outside of your piece, and of course the inside, which is towards your face. Then you're going to need a 10 inch by 9 inch piece of woven interfacing. Now I used a fusible interfacing, and the reason that I like the fusible interfacing is what you're going to iron this in place, and it will be adhere, and then you'll be ready to go on to the next step. Now we're not going to wait for that, we're going to move on. So the next thing I have here is I have one where I've ironed it down, and we're ready to do the next step, which would be to get your pattern piece out of your pattern, cut it out with your scissors, and then you're going to place it on top of your two fabrics. So you have your front and your back, and in this case, look, I ironed this to the wrong one. It should have been ironed to the front, but that's okay. I'll fix that later. So you're going to iron this, cut this out. So you'll cut out right along the curved edge. Once you cut that out, then you're going to come and you will go to your ironing mat and you will iron all of your seam allowances a half inch back. And that's why I put this interfacing was 9 inches. So it was 1 inch smaller than the backing and the front fabric, and I centered it on here. Once I ironed it down, I cut my piece out, and now I'm coming along and I iron all of my seam allowances down. A half inch, I think that's finally getting hot, a half inch seam allowance. Now I went with a half inch seam allowance because to ensure that you get your seam allowance inside, tucked inside, it just makes a little bit easier for most people. So once you have it like this, then you're ready to move on to the next step. The next step is you are going to take each of these pieces, and at this point you're going to need a ruler, and you're going to fold this in half, and you're going to add the dart. And then you may have seen the dart on the pattern. Now you can do other types of marking however you want, but I find that this is the easiest way for me to do it. And you will do it most likely with a pencil. So I came up here and I measured a half inch away over here on my edge. I put a dot, and then I measured down 1.5 inches. I also took my ruler and then I drew my line. Now this line with my pencil is my stitching line. Now you're going to do that on both here and also on the vocal fabric. So you'll have 4 darts on here, okay? So next thing you're going to do is you're going to go to your sewing machine and you're going to start sewing these. And you can see that I started stitching here and I ended here at this corner. I did back stitch at each of these places. So I did this on both of these pieces. So next thing that happens is, and this moves very quickly, you're going to come along and you will cut right down the center of these. Now you could press the seams to one direction and press the opposite one to the opposite direction. But if you open up these seams, it doesn't make it as bulky at the nose. So you want to go ahead and you want to cut all 4 of these. So once you've cut all 4 of these, you're going to iron your seams open. So you would come over here and I would iron my seams open and I would layer my pieces with the right size together. And then I would stitch along this edge, just the 2 long edges. After I did that, I came along with my pinking shears and I cut my seam allowance back. Now the reason that I did that is that way I don't have to go through the process of making clips, and everywhere that it needs to have relief in the concave, it does, and when it needs to curve in, it also has that allowance to do that because of the pinking. Other than that, what you can do is you can just take your scissors and you're going to want to cut up to about an eighth of an inch. You're going to make clips about a quarter to half inch apart on the concave surfaces of each of these. So now once you have that done, you need to reach inside. Now I do backstitch every time I stitch here just to make sure that things are going to stay together. Now this is the fun part. You're just going to reach inside here. You're going to hold this down and you are going to turn it right side out. Now once I've done this, you can either take your hair marker, which I can't seem to find at the moment, so I will just use my wooden pressing tool. But before I use my wooden pressing tool, I would come along with my iron, and I'm just the tip of my iron, and I would just press my seams in one direction. I'm pressing it. It's just going to make it stay that much flatter when I go to make these seams lay the way they're supposed to. So just going to come along and you're going to iron these just seams going in one direction. And then you're going to come back over here and do I have one? Yes, I have one over here where I've already done this. Now you can see I came back, I went in here with my pressing tool or my hair marker, and a hair marker is a white plastic marker. I'm still looking around my room for it and I can't find it. Once I pushed my seam allowances all the way out to the edge, then I came along and I ironed all of these two edges all nice and flat. It just makes it go together that much easier. So now you would have your piece and it's all ready for almost to finish. So now what we're gonna do, we're just gonna get our ruler back again. And our next step is to take the short ends here, and they line up perfectly because we iron them nicely. And then you're going to come over to your ruler again, and I want you to put a pin an inch away from the fold. So the fold is here, so I'm going to come about an inch, and I'm going to put my pin. And I'm going to do this on both ends. So whatever you do on one edge, you are going to do on the other one. So you are going to pin this, and then you're going to open it up. So I'm going to lay it down, and I'm going to stick my finger in there, or stick my pressing tool in there, something so that I can get that in there, and I can open up my pleat. Now what this does is creates a nice 1-inch pleat, one on either side of the center. Now this finished dimension from here to here should be approximately 2.5 inches, and it pretty much is 2.5 inches. It was a miracle. So now you're going to pin your pleats. So I'm going to pin my pleat, and I'm going to do that on both sides. And once we have this done on both sides, then we are ready to insert our elastic, sew around it, and our mask will be all finished. So we're going to do that same thing again. I kind of check my measurement. I don't want it too small and you don't want it too big. So I'm going to come with another pin. I need to find another pin. And I'll have both of these pleats ready. At this point, you're ready to put your elastic in. Now I've cut my elastic to the 7 inches. Now I'm just going to take my elastic and I am going to place it in between the two pieces of fabric, so right at the corner, as close as I can get it. And I will put a pin in here to hold this in place, just like this. Make sure that you don't get your elastic twisted when you put it on here. That won't be very comfortable. So lay it out flat, take that end, and come back over to the opposite edge and insert that where it needs to be. And then you're going to pin. Now you'll do this to both sides of your mask. And then what happens is you're going to sew it. So you're going to start at one end. I would start here. And I would stitch about an eighth of an inch from the edge. I'll come up here around. I'll go down, so I'm about a quarter inch away from my first stitching. I'm going to come back and I'm going to stitch back up here again. I will stitch all the way around this edge, about a scant eighth of an inch away from the edge, just to reinforce it. You'll come to this opposite side. You'll do the same thing. You'll come around here, go around. So we have this actually sewn once on the inside, twice on the outside. I really want to secure this elasticate here. And then you'd finish by following all the way through to the end over here. So I hope that that wasn't too fast, and I will be with you in 1 second. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you'll enjoy making your mask. I hope you'll wear your mask, and I hope that everyone will be safe. So please go to p3designs.com to download the PDF, and you will always be able to watch the video on there. You can also find it on my Facebook, or I probably will put it on Pinterest also. So there'll be many ways for you to find the downloadable pattern. So stay safe.